Hello. In this tutorial, I'm going to show you how to use the app Notability. So as the name implies, Notability is a note-taking app, but it's more than just note-taking. It also lets you open and annotate PDFs, Word documents, PowerPoints, pretty much any document you can open, it's going to change into a PDF. And then you can then do anything you want to it there. You can make notes, you can highlight. So it's really a nice feature, a really nice program with many features. The reason why we're showing you this is that BU now has an electronic curriculum initiative, and that we'd really like to save the amount of paper that we use. So using Notability, all the things you would normally do with paper, read a PDF, look at a PowerPoint, make notes, you can actually do everything now just in Notability. Notability is available for tablets and for computers in the Mac range, so using iOS. I'm using this obviously on a tablet, but you can also get it for your MacBook or any Mac laptop or desktop. The price right now, I'm recording this in July of 2015, Notability cost me $3. I think it's a little more expensive. I think it's $15 for a Mac computer. But for $3, if you already have an iPad, I think it's a really great tool. And I'm going to show you how to use Notability to do the things you would normally do now on paper. So the first thing I'm going to do, obviously going to open up Notability, so it's just this app right here. So I'm just going to tap this to open it up. So the first thing you're going to see when you go into Notability, this is sort of all the files I've already previously saved myself. So the file structure in Notability is a little bit weird. So I'm just going to click up here on this little plus so I can see what the file structure is. So I basically have two options. I can create subjects and create dividers. So dividers are just sort of master headings for your subjects, and the subjects the actual folders themselves. I don't really worry about the dividers. I just make subjects and folders. I really don't keep things in my Notability library that long. I'm going to show you in a few minutes how you can send things to Dropbox. So I normally just keep the projects I'm working on right now on my tablet in the actual memory of Notability. Any project I've done previously, I send to Dropbox. And you can always pull it back up and keep working on things once you send them to Dropbox. So it's really a nice way to kind of store things you're not using. If you get to the point that your Dropbox folder is full, you can certainly just go to your laptop, move all those things out of Dropbox onto a folder on your laptop and just archive them there. Okay, so still thinking about sort of the things that we normally do in a computer. So I just, or with notes I should say, so I'm going to show you how to create a brand new note from scratch. So the way I'm going to do that, I'm just going to click on this little icon here, this little sort of pen and paper. So now this is a blank note. So you'll see that by default it just gives it the name of the date and time that you created it right here, but obviously you can change that to anything you like. I'm not going to worry about that, this is just sort of a test note. So you have different options here, these icons. So this little T here is a text tool, so if I click on that, I can now start to type. It's going to make a little virtual keyboard here on the bottom of the screen once I start to type, and I can just type, you know, anything, so say just say literally type anything. You can also use a wireless keyboard, or if you have a tablet with a wireless keyboard built into the case, you can certainly use that. It's very good at recognizing input from other devices in that way. Probably what most people do though, especially if you're working with a PDF or PowerPoint or something, you're probably just going to write on it by hand with using a stylus or your finger. So the tool for that, this little second tool here, is a pencil tool. If I hold this for a second, I can see that I have the options. I can obviously change the color. These two options here, I can change sort of the width of the line. I can change sort of the point size if I want, say, bigger type. Say if I click here, say, and I draw a line, it's going to be much larger than if I do. If I now go back here, I can make this sort of a smaller line. You'll see it's a thinner line when it draws. So whatever, you know, style works for you, you have plenty of options there. Some people like to use different colors for different things. So maybe things you really want, whatever you want to write, or write in red, or write in blue or yellow. Again, whatever the choice is for you is fine. You have many options there. So I really don't want these two squiggles on my screen. This fourth tool over here is obviously just an eraser. So I can just erase those and it's going to go away. The nice thing about the erase tool, so say if I draw over text, so say I draw over this type anything that I wrote, or if that had been a PowerPoint or some other document I pulled in, it's not going to erase that text because it knows the original text was on the page that you superimposed something onto. You want to keep that where it is. So one of the things with writing, again, you don't have to use a stylus. As you know, Steve Jobs said the best stylus in the world is your finger, which is really what iPads are designed to work with. But say I write something, again, I'm just going to write something. I'm not very creative today, I guess. And my handwriting is terrible, so don't worry about that. I usually use a stylus when I'm doing this for real. So say this something is very, very large and obviously hideous to look at. If I don't want it, and it's also sort of crooked going up to the right, if I want to sort of make this smaller, more manageable to fit the screen better, if I go to this tool here, this little pair of scissors, I can actually capture anything I've created on the screen using a stylus, and now I could make this larger or smaller just by grabbing two fingers and zooming it in, and I can also rotate that, which is nice. So if I need to do something, in this case, no pun intended, I can use that kind of scissor tool to go through and sort of change the size of that text or the orientation. The next tool that's this little hand here. So if I'm back, say, in the pencil tool and I want to move around the screen, if you only use one finger, you can't see my hand, I'm using one finger here, you can see that I'm actually making a line instead. You have to use two fingers if you want to move the screen up and down, and sometimes it's not very sensitive. So a few things you can do, I'm going to kind of pinch this back to make it a little bit smaller. And you can see any time I touch the screen, even to try to manipulate it, it just keeps drawing these red lines. So what you can do, if you just want to move up and down the screen, this tool here, the hand, now makes, you can't actually input anything onto the note, but now you can just scroll up and down the screen or zoom in or zoom out using, when you select that little hand as the tool. So it's a nice way sometimes if you don't want to just keep making these sort of accidental marks in the screen, I just usually click that little hand and move them down the screen wherever I want to do. You can also, of course, like any application, undo is this little button over here. And I can just click on that and it's going to make the last mark that I did go away. If I go back to the tool here, so you can see that those red marks I made accidentally went away when I clicked on the undo. So there are a few other features here that are very nice in Notability that are pretty unique, I think. So I don't really worry about this, but I'll show it to you because we're here. If I wanted to sort of change the style of the paper that's behind my note, if I click on this little wrench tool over here, I can actually change the paper. So I could make this, you know, graph paper or line paper, whatever, different colors. So just for the sake of argument, I'm going to click on this little graph paper one here. And you can see now it is a graph paper grid behind me, so if it's easier to write in graph paper or line paper, that's fine. There are also things you can do, though, that say you wanted to actually make a voice recording. This microphone here, so if you click on that microphone, it's going to start to make a voice recording into the recording I'm doing right now. You can see that the icon is now activated and it's recording away. I can just click on that again to stop it. And this little arrow here, this little carrot, if I click on that, I can now get the option to play this back. So I'm just going to pause speaking for a second so you can hear the playback here.
Make a voice recording into the...
Okay, that's probably enough of that. So that's really nice. Unfortunately, with BU, the new Prism curriculum, just the way the copyright works, you're not allowed to record lectures yourself in a lecture hall. That's why we use Echo 360 to capture that. But if you were sort of, you know, maybe brainstorming yourself ideas, or if you were at a conference or something and you're allowed to record audio, so you could certainly record audio as you're sitting there in the auditorium making your notes, which is really nice. Along those same lines, when you have the ability to do something, so say you were in a auditorium someplace, like at a conference, and the speaker on the podium was showing something you wanted to see that was interesting, if I click on this little plus here, there's some additional tools I can use too. So you can actually use your camera, where it says here photo, you can, now that your iPad's camera will be activated, you can take a snapshot of something and integrate that into the notes you were taking. You can also, this take a photo here. This photo option, if you had something in the actual pictures saved on your tablet, you could integrate a picture that you already had yourself in your media file, bring it back into the note. With this figure, which I think is nice, again, if you're in a lecture and someone's explaining something that isn't in their PowerPoint, say, and you want to capture it, so I'm just going to click on figure here. So now you can kind of draw a graph yourself. So they were talking about natural distribution. I could quickly draw my, you know, bell curve here myself and put sort of the standard deviation thing. Hopefully yours would look better than mine, but you get the idea. So it's really nice that it gives you many, many ways to get information you need into the note that you're making at that time, sort of on the fly in real time. And then finally, there's different ways to view sort of the note that you've made. So this tool here, this kind of two little sheets of paper, if I click on this, if this were a multiple page note, you can see that it's going to display the different pages of the note. You can also, if I wanted to, I could click here and delete this note. And if I wanted to search something that's in this note, there's only probably three words in my note now, just click on this little magnifying glass and it brings up a search. That only searches the note that you're in, so unfortunately if you're looking at all the notes sort of back in your subject folder, it's not going to look through the text of all of those, it's just going to look in the text of the note that's actually up in front of you now. Okay, so that's kind of just a quick overview of what these different tools in Notability did. I did skip one, but you'll see what I'm going to do with that in a second when we get back to actually using Notability for the sort of things you're going to use it for in your everyday experience as a student. So I want to save this note. This is, say, a pretty good note, although it actually isn't, but whatever the case may be. For illustration's sake, it certainly is functional. So I'm going to click this little arrow here to go back to sort of my home screen. And automatically, you can see it saved this note that we just created is saved, which is nice. So I have different options if I wanted to. If I didn't like this note, I can click Edit up here, and I could certainly go through and delete using this little trash can here. But I want to save this note because it's, you know, for this purpose, it's certainly fine. I'm just going to click Done now because I'm all set. So I'm going to click on this note again. So I mentioned before I can save a note like this to Dropbox. So I'm just going to click on this icon here, this sort of box with an arrow sticking out of it. And now I have the options, where do I want to send this particular note? So like I said, I send it to Dropbox. You have all these other options too where you can store your notes while you're working on them. So I'm going to click on Dropbox here. And you see by default, I'm going to use this paper sort of format here. So paper is Notability's sort of native setting for saving a file. So the nice thing is I can save it as a paper. If I bring it back to my tablet later, I can still make notes, I can still annotate, I can still write it, which is nice. If you save it as a PDF, obviously you could send that to somebody else as an annotated PDF. So maybe you're studying with a friend. You could make all of your notes in the PDF, send it to your friend. Your friend could open it up, and then whatever program they're using, if they're using Notability or Mendeley or something, they could open it up, you know, save their notes, send it back to you as a PDF. So it's just easier for someone else to read outside of the sort of Notability universe. If you save it as a PDF, but it still will work just fine. It's not a problem. So I'm going to send this to Dropbox. It's pretty quick. I mean, we're on the BU network right now, which is a pretty fast network. So like I said, I'm going to show you now how you can pull things back. So I'm going to go back here to my home page by clicking this little arrow here. So I'm back on my home page. I'm going to delete this note just so you can see that I'm not just opening it. I actually got it back from Dropbox. So I'm going to click on Edit here. I'm going to delete this note. So I'm going to choose that and click the little trash can. And now that note, I'm going to say delete one note. I'm going to say delete it. So now that note is gone. So it's no longer there. If I wanted to get that back, because I did send it to Dropbox, the way I do that, I'm just going to obviously click out of here to get back to my sort of other apps that are available for me. I'm going to click here on Dropbox. So this is going to be sorted by date. So you see, here's when we just added this July 17th, 2015. That's the day I'm recording this particular tutorial. I'm just going to click on this to open that note up again in Dropbox. So if I want to send this back to Notability so I can use it, again, the same little icon I clicked in Notability to send it to Dropbox. I'm going to click that same icon here to send it back to Notability. So I'm just going to click here. And I have this option here where it says Open In. I'm going to click on that. And now I have the option to open that in Notability. So now this is a brand new note because I deleted it, doesn't know that it's here. So I'm going to say in this case, I'm going to create a new note. It's going to bring that same title back over. And now it's whatever, where I'm going to put that particular subject. I'm just going to say my regular default. Oh, sorry, didn't want to do that. I just want to say create new note here. And then click on import. So now it brought that note back. Here it is exactly in its full glory here. So it's really a nice thing you can do. And again, I normally do this with PDFs and things that are more substantive, but at least it's a nice option to do. Okay, so this is sort of just the how to save notes and also how Notability works in general. So how do you use it for the types of things you want to use it for? So what I'm going to do now, I'm just going to back up to the home page here again. I'm just going to exit Notability here for a second. So one thing you're going to probably want to do quite often with Notability is work on the syllabi for the different courses that you're taking. So I'm just going to open up Safari here. And you can see that I'm right into Blackboard on my iPad. So I do teach a course for GMS, so I do have my own Blackboard page as an instructor. I'm also a grader in a few other classes. So I'm just going to open up the class that I teach, which is this one here, this GMS MS640. I'm going to open the most recent one, 2015. So if I wanted to import a syllabus into my Notability account, I'm just going to go over here, obviously, where the syllabus lives. I'm just going to open this up. So right here. So I'm going to get the option where it says here, open in on my iPad. I'm just going to say open in, and of course, I want to open it in Notability. That's the program I want to use. So it's going to ask me again if I want to create a new note or add to another note. The nice thing is if you had multiple notes, so say you had two or three PDFs in the same subject you want to kind of all put in one note, you can just click here where it says add to other note and add it to that note, but I'm going to make this a distinct note by itself. So I'm going to say here, create new note, so those three pages in my syllabus, and then click on import. So even though this is a Word document, it pulls it in no problem. So, you know, it's going to change this into a PDF. It changes everything to a PDF, but it works with all kinds of different, you know, options for files, PowerPoints, and things too. So again, here is that, that syllabus. So again, if I want to make notes, so I can click here, again, on the little pencil tool. So if I want to make any kind of notes, like say, circle my co-instructor, the great Dr. Teresa Davies, and make some note, say, like I just said here, great. And again, pardon my inability to write. It's terrible handwriting here. So whatever you want to make here for notes. So you can go through anything you make, any kinds of changes. So anything you want to do, highlight, all those sorts of things. It's really great. So it's really an easy way. And again, as I said before, to scroll through the whole thing, I would just click on the little hand tool here, just so I'm not going to make any stray marks as I scroll through. And now I can scroll through and read the entire syllabus. So I can pinch, I can zoom, whatever I want to do to go through and annotate that particular document. You're probably also going to work with PDFs quite a bit too, so I'm just going to back out here, and this is going to save automatically when I go back to that home page. Again, I'm going to quit Notability here for a second, go back to Safari. So say I had an article in PubMed that I wanted to capture. So this is a paper that the librarians here at BU wrote a few years ago. So I want to get this as the PDF. I'm just going to click here where it says the PMC PubMed Central Full Text. And I want to find that PDF option. And you can see in this case, it's right here. Every journal is a little bit different, but you'll normally either see the words PDF, letters PDF, or the little icon, you know, the kind of that red squiggle on a white background. So it's going to click here to get that PDF. So again, that same exact operation that was previously a Word document, this is obviously a PDF. I want to click here where it says open in, and again, I want to open in Notability. So now Notability is going to open up again. I get the same query. Do I want to create a new note, add to another note? So I'm going to say create a new note and then say import. It's going to bring in the full text of that PDF. And now the thing I have been avoiding showing you just because I think it works best here as something you do with PDFs, of course, is going to be highlight. So this tool here next to the pencil is the highlighter. So I can go through. Again, I can change the color so that kind of bilious green I don't really like. I want the traditional sort of yellow highlighter color. So I can just go through here now and highlight, you know, wherever that happens to be, whatever text that I want. I know that many medical students like to use different color highlighters for different things. So maybe information you really want to really have to memorize, you want to make it red, the things you don't need to know, green. Again, whatever color scheme you want to use. So I can certainly do that here. I can just change that color and then go through and highlight, you know, whatever else I need to highlight there. So it's really nice that instead of having to carry all those different PDFs around with you and your whole little bandolier of highlighters, you can do it all right here on your tablet. You can send that back to Dropbox. You can save it for any place you want to save it. You can share it with people. So all the different things you typically do with paper and pens and highlighters for studying, for reading, for gathering information, you can have Notability do all that for you just in your tablet that you probably carry every day anyway. And I said it only costs $3. Thank you for watching this video. If you have any questions, please feel free to contact us at the reference desk. We're open Monday through Friday from 8:30 to 5. We're also open now on Saturdays and Sundays from 10 to 6. So feel free to give us a call at 617-638-4228. Send us an email at refquest@bu.edu, or feel free to drop by the reference desk on the 12th floor of the library.